Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. الخطبة today about get closer. This is the khutbah is about. Get closer to where? In actuality, I'm giving this khutbah to myself. I want to hear it. I want to enjoy it. I want to live it. If you want to be part of it, alhamdulillah. If not, it's between you and yourself, between you and Allah. Get closer mean get closer. That mean move forward. That mean get more closer. To what? If you want to know what it is I'm talking about, each one of us had went through some kind of experience. He or she, you dead or you well, experience. You went through experience that you like or you love something or someone. This is reality. Friends, wife, a car, whatever it is. What is the reaction and what kind of interaction happened between you and this thing that you love or this one that you love? Now, if you can understand this example, and the Prophet used to draw in the line and used to give example and parable so that people can understand it and live it. And this is what I'm trying to tell you. Did you ever been in love with somebody? He or she, a friend, a businessman, whatever it is. And now when you go get to know that he's the dean of the students, or that he's a professor in your college. Now we are trying to find means and ways to get closer. Greeting, a smile, try to introduce yourself, try to ask if he can visit you or if you can talk with him. Why? This is reality. This is us as a human being. But we want to take this parable or this example and talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Indeed, we have created mankind. And we well acquainted with what is his soul whispering to him. And we are closer to him than his jugular vein. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said also, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيب لي وليؤمن بي. And when my slave servant ask you Muhammad concerning me, inform them that I am near. Let them answer my call. And let them believe in me. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like is saying about Musa alayhi salam, وَنَادَيْنَاهُ مِنْ جَانِبِ الطُّورِ الْأَيْمَنِ وَقَرَّبْنَاهُ نَجِيًّا. When Allah called in Moses alayhi salam from the right side of the mountain of Sinai, Tur, and he said, and we brought him closer in the talk, the conversation. Allah give him this means. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is near. But now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made means and wants us to get closer to him. Now I hope that somebody can understand my broken English and can try to reflect in this khutbah how I can get closer to Allah. And the simple fact that some people complaining about that upstairs, as example, is not opening until 1:45. While half of the masjid is open and empty because they want to go far. They don't want to get near. This is simple example. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that if people keep delaying themselves until Allah delays them, we have a problem of getting closer. Three people in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed by the masjid and they saw the Prophet and they have a class. So one got and he tried to find a spot and a space and he stick and sat down there to listen. The second person, he was shy, sat behind the circle. The third one take a look and kept walking. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the Sahaba, should I inform you about the news and the tales of these three people? أَمَّا الْأَوَّلْ فَآوَى فَآوَى اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. As for the first one, he came closer to Allah. He came near to Allah. He made an effort to sit in the halaqa. He tried to leave early hijab in the school to be in the first line. No, we don't have to worry about it. 5 minutes before two, now I'm going to leave my office so I can catch first raka'ah and record it ijumah for me. So we are delaying ourselves. Instead that he say, come closer, we say, let's get a distance. And somebody tried to compare and telling me, other messages, they doing this and bought acres and bought this and that, we're closing up the stairs. It's fine, he can go there. But I'm telling you, when you're going to save your soul, when you're going to get closer to Allah, when you're going to try to find a way that you can approach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is near already, but you is the one to need now to get closer to Allah. Allah made means for you. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying what? أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدٌ. The most closer position and time that you can be to Allah when you are in prostration. Because you take yourself, your nose, that sometimes in the sky and your forehead, and you put it down with all humiliation and submission, showing your slavery before Allah. Now this brings you more closer. The more man tawada'a lillahi rafa'a, that whosoever get closer to Allah. Prostrate. This is something in our deen that most of us are not paying attention to it. As a result of this, assalamu alaikum, assalamu alaikum, shuma, boom, what's going on? And you can stand outside for half an hour, talk and talk and talk. Why? Because we did not see security. We don't see sakina. We don't see tranquility from our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we want to run away. We want to go to the second floor. We want to go lay down or lean against the wall while the masjid is open. And after this, we don't feel the deen. We're fighting with hijab. We're fighting with growing our beard. We're fighting with making salah and take our time. Why? The love is there. The love is not there. Try to remember when you saw this handsome man or when you saw this beautiful girl and now you're thinking about to go and propose for her or that whatever it is and now you're buying gift and now you try to use the phone and talk and you try to understand. Get closer. Why? Because comes as a result of love. So if we don't have the love of Allah, the love of the deen, now the cigarette is more closer to us than the miswak, shaving the beard and imitating the kuffar, you understand? Taking hijab, walking with the pen, much easier. Why? Because we don't have it. The love is not there. The love is not there. How the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to stand in the prayer, not the obligatory prayer. He made all the 5-time prayers. He stand up during the night in tahajjud. In tahajjud. And they cry and weep. And his feet swallow. Because he have this kind of love to Allah. And he trying to get closer to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran. Kalla. لا تطعه واسجد واقترب. This Abu Jahl telling you better stop making salah. We have a lot of Abu Jahl in our life with a personality. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this man Abu Jahl. But we have a lot of Abu Jahl nowadays. Even your own soul that between your two ribs that became an enemy of you. So Allah said, nay, O Muhammad, don't listen to him. Don't listen to your shaitan. Don't listen to the TV. Don't listen to the talk show. Don't listen to all these people who try to take you away from Allah's way. Kalla, la tuti'hu, wasjud. And get more closer. This is what Allah said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Don't worry about Abu Jahl. Don't pay him attention. Don't listen to him. لا تطيعه. And what else? He said, wasjud and prostrate yourself. And what? And get closer. And get nearer to us, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do we ever try to think about how we can get closer to Allah? This is something is missing from our life. Most of us, illa man rahim Allah. That we, when we make the salah, we making it maybe, you understand, in 2 minutes. And we go up and down so fast and quick. Why? Because no enjoyment there. There is no love there. There is no closeness there. So there is no anything, it's empty. And we expecting this will happen what? Because we come to Jum'ah. No. No, brother, no, sister. It's a continuation. If you love somebody, you love what? You love his friend. If you love somebody, you try to get closer to them. If you love somebody, you want to talk more to him. Do you love the Quran? Oh, brother, yes. This is the book of Allah. Yes, I know the book of Allah. How many times do you open the Quran? And how many times they turn the TV every day, not every week, but the Quran, when Ramadan comes, after Ramadan, what's happening? Where is the love? How are you going to get it? You are not getting closer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made himself almighty to be close, and he doesn't need us. And we, the one who are in need for Allah, we're running away from Allah. And Allah said, "Fafirru ila Allah." Not firru from Allah. Listen carefully what Allah said. "Fafirru ila Allah." Run. Run to Allah. Not dragging your feet to Allah. Do you know the mosque? They call what? Baytullah, the house of Allah. Not that Allah need a house, but this attribution, you understand, for an honor. He says the house of Allah. So, how much do you see the house of Allah? Every week, count to yourself. How many times do you open the Quran a day or a week? Count to yourself. Now you can know that you are not close. And you think you're going to be close by making Jum'ah and leave. We have to face the reality. We have to understand why deen became hard for us. Why we could not sit down? Can you imagine? Can you imagine? People born and raised as Muslims, talking the language of the Quran, and it's so hard for them to come to one single class in Arabic, you could not even count in your two hands. You could not even count in your right hand. How many? Yo, what are you talking about? You crazy? I'm Muslim. My grandma, all of us, all tribes, all the country is Muslim. Yeah. We know. The love is not there. The caring is not there. Getting closer, this is something almost from most of the Muslim dictionary is not there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He opens the means for you and you become closer to Allah, and listen in this hadith al-Qudsi, that Rabbul Izzah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying, من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whosoever show animosity against one of my awliya, one of my friends, those who close to me, فقد آذنته بالحرب, I will declare a war against him. Observe the life of Muslims everywhere. Muslims are killing Muslims. Forget about kuffar. No, Muslims killing Muslims. Why? What's going on? There is a problem. And Allah is saying, if you show animosity to my friend, my wali, the one I love, oh, because Allah doesn't love us in this case. So now He left to us. He left for us to kill each other. Because we think Islam is only going to make Jum'ah, and after this, everything is fine. من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Whosoever show animosity, how are you going to be a wali of Allah and you are not near to Allah? You don't love the things that Allah love. You don't hate the things that Allah hate. You did not carry out the things that Allah said, do it. How are you going to be friend of Allah? Okay? ولا يزال عبدي وما تقرب إلي عبدي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته علي. My slave servant could not come closer to me with anything more than what I made it obligatory in him. So this your means. The 5-time prayers, the fasting of Ramadan, making the Hajj, all these things is obligatory. This is the pillar, the foundation, the fundamental of Islam. There is no way you can get closer and more closer to Allah with anything better than performing the basic principles of Islam. Let's assume that you graduate and that you successfully fulfill all these things. Okay? Because we're talking about coming near, coming closer. So you're coming closer through the obligatory things in Islam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ. Getting closer and closer and closer. And my slave servant continuing getting more closer to me with the nawafil, with the optional voluntary acts. You give your zakah, there is something called sadaqah. You made isha, there is something called witr or qiyam al-layl. You made salat al-zuhr, there is sunnah or there is zikr after this. Now there is optional deed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that my slave servant continuing getting more closer. So Allah wants you to get closer. Get closer, get more near to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls some people al-muqarrabun, those who are near to Allah, in positions, in ranks, in everything. You don't want to be among al-muqarrabin? You don't want to be among those people? All what you care about, you understand the name and the titles and the medals, and you have more and more. When we're going to think about be among those who get closer, ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل. A lot of نوافل, a lot of optional deeds. حتى أحبه. And as a result of getting more closer to me, doing optional deeds, I will love my slave. I will love my slave servant, Abdullah, Abdurrahman, Muhammad, Ibrahim, Ahmed. I will love him. Why? Because he's doing optional deeds. He lives far, so it's not obligatory to pray with the Jama'ah. He can pray it at home. But he will like to make it this optional. And I'm going to drive to the masjid. So what's the result? Listen to this. This is not a woman you're going to get married to. This is not a job that you're going to get. This is not a degree that somebody is going to give you. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ وَيَدَهُ الَّتِي يَبْطِشُ بِهَا وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا وَلَئِنْ سَأَلَنِي لَأَعْطِيَنَّهُ وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعْذَنَّهُ. Why? Why? You can be a millionaire. You can be protected and guided by Allah 24/7. Why you rejecting it? Why you running away? Why you are not getting closer to Allah? Say, my slave servant continuing coming closer to me by performing optional deeds until I love him. And if I love him, I became his vision, which he sees with. I'll be his ear, which are hearing, which he listen with. I'll be his hand, which he strikes and move with it. And his leg, which he walk with it. That means, wallah, Allah will guide every limb and every part of your body. Now Allah will be waliyak, will be your guardian, will be your protector. Why we running away? It's so beautiful. This Islam is not a hardship. It's something to enjoy. Why you think people come in at 2? Look, 4 minutes before Jum'ah. Now look, how many? 10, 15. You can look behind yourself and see how many people come in. Why? Because it's something like, they call it saddikhanat, fulfilling the empty spot. Put anything inside. This is not a deal. This is not the way the deen is. This deen came to make you happy in this life before even the hereafter. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. So the deen came to give you the blessing and the good and the best of this dunya before the hereafter. So why are you running away? Why are you going farther away? That because he didn't get to know what's Islam yet. He did not experience what is love and what is near. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who withdraw themselves, those who bring themselves closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not from those who run away from Allah and the deen of Allah. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. La ilaha الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. I would love to continue this subject for myself before you. But I want to remind you that we're still in the month of Shawwal. And for some who did not fast since 60 days of Shawwal, you still have opportunity. We're talking about getting closer to Allah. So there is a good deed that you can do. Whosoever observes the fasting of Ramadan, follow it by 60 days from Shawwal, he will be rewarded as if he had fast the whole year. One last thing I want to remind myself as well as you. We are in Shawwal. That means we have max 8 weeks before Hajj. Don't wait. I feel sad, really. Wallahi, I'm telling you, honestly. I feel sad for some people. They have all the means. Money, right, health, name it. And they went to different places, right, left, east, west. but they did not make Hajj until now. You don't know. You don't know what's going to happen to you tomorrow. You don't know. Brothers, Allah made Hajj obligatory in you. And out of His mercy that He made it once in the lifetime. And if you are 50 or 60 and you did not make Hajj until now, you need to cry on yourself. Cry in behalf of yourself, especially if you have the means. Excuses is never going to stop. And always everything, something will come up. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying, "Man arada al-hajj falyata'ajjal," that you're supposed to hasten, not to delay. So my advice, humble advice to you, doesn't matter what is company you go with, I'm not here commercializing to try to tell you come to Hajj with me. No, I'm saying to you, go to Hajj. You have less than 2 months. I advise you that you leave this khutbah and you go to the post office and get application to renew your passport or to get a passport or do something about it now, while the khutbah may still hot inside. Do not. Wallahi. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, the Jannah is closer to one of you more than his shoelaces, and hellfire is closer to you. You don't know, you can drop dead, and this is it. And after this, you meet Allah, and He give you all the means, and He didn't make Hajj. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us, all of us, that we get closer to Him, that we can enjoy the love of Islam and the beauty of Islam. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Amen.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واعتدلوا استووا واعتدلوا تراصوا Those persons in the reception area, please move forward. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين ليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Brothers and sisters, we have a lot of dates. If anybody care for that, it's for free. Please, let me know.
Thank you. Oh my God.